Hello and welcome to another episode in the GDScript Fundamental Tutorial Series. In this episode, we will be taking a look at static and dynamic programming languages. So to start with that, what exactly is a programming language? Well, all programming languages are designed to translate human-readable code into machine instructions. That's basically what a programming language is. Now let's go ahead and take a look at this process. So no matter what language you're using, it will always be referred to as source code. In this case, it could be C++, Python, PHP, in our case, GDScript, etc. Now, what our computer does is it first takes our source code and it compiles it in what we call a compiler. We refer to this process as compile time. What the compiler does is it translates your source code into an executable file, basically machine language. Now, once we have that executable file, we then go ahead and we execute it. Keep in mind that all code is executed at the central processing unit, also referred to as a CPU. And the process of actually executing your code is called runtime. Let's go ahead and talk about static and dynamic type languages. So a static type language is a language where the type checking occurs at compile time, whereas in dynamic type languages, type checking occurs at runtime. Now for static type language, variables don't need to be defined before they are used. However, in dynamic type languages, variables must be defined before they are used. Let's go ahead and take a look at a quick example. So as you can see here in our static type language, we must first declare a variable, but notice how we do not have to assign anything to it. We can do that later in our code. However, in a dynamic type language, our variable must be declared. For example, this is how you would write code in PHP. Now, on top of a language being static or dynamic, there's also something called a strong and weak type language. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So a strong typing just means that variables are bound to a data type. Self-explanatory. And basically, weak typing is the opposite, which just means that a variable is not bound to a specific data type. Now that we took a look at static and dynamic types along with strong and weak types, let's go ahead and take a look at what makes a language static. Basically, a static programming language is a programming language in which operations are done at compile time. Most static languages are statically typed. Compare that to a language that's dynamic. A dynamic programming language is a programming language in which operations otherwise done at compile time can be done at runtime. For example, in GDScript, it is possible to change the type of a variable, size of an array, or objects during runtime. Most dynamic languages are dynamically typed. However, this does not have to be the case. Now, the pros of dynamic languages is your flexibility and how you can assign variables and write code. On top of that, dynamic languages are more or less abstracted, so therefore there is less code to write. Now, the pros of a static language is that you will have better performance. You will be able to catch mismatches in code during compile time versus dynamics checking in runtime. And on top of that, because of that, you can reduce errors when writing your code. Or rather, it's faster to catch your errors. I went ahead and made a graph of an example of different languages. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. As you can see here on the y-axis, we have at our top a strong language, strong type, and at the bottom a weak type. To our left, dynamic, and to the right, static. Keep in mind that all languages are always on a spectrum. Some of the differences are subtle. However, we can take a look at some of the languages. For example, C# is a strong and static language, along with Java. Python is also a strong dynamic language. Now, if we take a look at the bottom, we have our weak and dynamic languages, such as JavaScript, PHP, and to our right, with the static and weak types, we have our C language and C++. Well, that's all I have for you in this episode. Thank you for subscribing, and thank you for clicking the like button. I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Have an amazing day.